We have just created this form, and now we want the form to create a new record on our data source. That, in this case, is an Excel spreadsheet, right? We could think that's just playing the app, filling the information and saving, but it happens, it's not. If we play the app right now, with the form we just created and just changed these fields, we can see that we have this message, no item to display. Well, in order to use the forms, we need to call a couple of functions first to let the form know that's going to be used to create a new record. Because right now Power Apps doesn't know if this form is going to be used to create or add a record, and you need to tell it by using the function called NewForm. I'm going to show you an example of how it works, a diagram that I draw on Miro, to show what are the steps we need to do when using a form in Power Apps to create. So these are the steps we need to follow to create a new record in your data source. First, we need to call a function called newForm and inform what's the form name that we want to use to create a new record. Once we filled all the information we want, we then call SubmitForm. Usually this is put in the save button. And then after the form is submitted, we have in the form properties two actions that could be used to decide what are the next steps. We have onSuccess that will run when the form saves the data successfully, and we have the onFail that will run when we get an error. In the onSuccess, usually I go back to the previous page, for example the home page, or navigate to the contacts list page or the page that we want the user to go. And in the onFail, we can notify the user that was an error. Now let's go back to the app and put those formulas in action. The first formula is the new form that we need to call every time we want to create a new record. I'm going to call this function right before I navigate to this page. I could put the function in the onVisible property, but I'm going to put in the home screen new contact buttons, because later we want to use the same form to edit a record. And if I put the function in the onVisible of that screen, that won't work. So what I'm going to do is, right before the navigate, I'm going to tell the app that I want to use that form to be a new form that will create new contacts. So I'm going to type new form, open the parentheses, and pass the name of the form that's of FRM contacts. Close the parentheses, and now to separate these two calls, two functions, I need to put a semicolon. Depending on the language, it may be two semicolons. And okay, you need to test, because, for example, if I put another symbol here that's not the correct, it will show an error, it will highlight the error. And then you can see that that's not the correct thing. So you put two semicolons in case you put only one and doesn't work for you, right? Okay, now once I click on this button, it will call the new form and then navigate. Let's play the app and click on it. The new form now was called, and then we can see the form right here, meaning that now we can fill the form, different from before that was showing that message no item or something like this. Okay, if I click on save, if I fill this information and click on save, that won't work, because now, remember, we have to call the submit form to tell Power Apps to send this form data to the data source. Let's exit the play mode, go to the save button, and then call the submit form. Okay, open parentheses, pass the name of the form as the first argument, and then close the parentheses. This will send the form to the data source. Remember now that we have the onSuccess and onFail property of the form. If I click on the form, I can go to the onSuccess property. Here, onSuccess. And then we could navigate back to the previous page. We can put, just for example, back right here. And then once the form is submitted, it will go back to the previous page that in my case was the home screen. Then we have also the on failure that we could use to show something to the user. We can use the notify function to let the user know that there was a problem. So let's pass a text here saying there was a problem saving your data. We can add more things if you want, but let's keep it simple right now. Okay, now we have the submit form that will send the form data, and in the on success, we have the back function that will make it return to the previous page. Let's give it a try. I'm going to play the app. Let's create a new record. So name will be Cassandra, Cassandra Web, email cassie@mrpowerappssoft.com, phone, let's just put any number here. Right now we don't have the options for department because we still need to implement this, and we are going to see in the next videos. By default, it doesn't know what are the options because we are connecting to a source that's very simple. It's an Excel spreadsheet. If it was SharePoint lists with the type of choices, it would show already. Or if it was a Dataverse database, also with the choices column, it would show already the options here. But we are going to see how to do very soon. Let's keep blank right now. In the comment, we can add any comment here. This is a comment. Once I click save, it's saving the data to our data source. It will call the onSuccess if it's successfully. It was, because we saw that it returned to the previous page. Now if I go to find contacts, we have this gallery that's connected to our data source. And we see here in the very end the new contact that was created, meaning that this row is now in your spreadsheet. You can go there and open your spreadsheet to check if the contact is there, but I'm sure it is because it's showing right here. In the next video, we are going to see more details about the form component, learn how to create required fields, for example, and other simple changes that we can perform. See you in there.